Hey there, everyone! Welcome back to Let's Play... Super Mario Brothers! Yes, this is actually a thing. No, this is not some weird secret. This is actually part of the game. Unlike Mario, though, we got a gun. Also, I looked up a little thing about the containers, and it turns out, yes, there is one container per map, and in order to unlock the secret abilities, you do have to find, like, basically every single container in order. You know, honestly, I'm considering actually, like, after I beat the game, actually getting all the containers, because I am curious about the abilities. Also, turns out you don't actually have to get every single file in order to unlock the secrets. You just have to get, like, 95% of them before a certain area. Which is still most of them, but yeah. Meaning, I may have actually missed one here or there. Wait, do I have to... Oh. Of course. Oh, you thought it was gonna end at Mario? Nope, we got Contra now! And yes, There's even a fortress boss at the end of the freaking area. That didn't go well. And that's Contra cleared. What could possibly be next? Yeah, I'm actually not entirely sure what that was supposed to be. But whatever it is, we're not doing it because the simulation broke. You'll remember that Base 4 deals with reality-altering technology and stuff, so it makes a little bit more sense when you know that. Come on, can I get over there? No, there's like an invisible wall, it won't let you. Okay. We're running low on ammo from that. It's actually bad considering the enemies we're dealing with right now. Here we go. You know, it will help getting these throughout the playthrough because I'll actually be able to look back on these videos and like reference where all of these hidden containers were. And yeah, that's the one that we found after getting enough documents last time. So yeah, that was a different container. We got that one. We got that one. I don't think I remember that one. Did we get that one? Pretty sure we got that one. I know we got that one too. Oh, yeah, we got that one. Anyway. Okay, what do we do here? Okay, prepare the rocket. Now how do we do that? Oh. Not this time, guys. Yes, we are actually about to nuke the entire city. It's the only way to be sure. We should probably get on that. Can any of these other doors open? No, they do not. Hopefully we'll be safe from the blast. Aha! Hidden container! Wait, why am I suddenly super jumping? So hold up a sec. Oh, that just goes. Oh. I think one of the abilities you get from the containers is actually a super jump. To be fair, the information that I got before was actually from the older, plot structure file and stuff, so I don't know, maybe they changed how it works? Because the way it looked, I needed no less than 22 containers and had to have every container up to that point in order to unlock the first ability. And see, the reason I think a super jump is one of the abilities is because I've seen someone else play this before, and in their game, like, they were pretty late in the game, and, like, their character was jumping way higher than normal, so I thought maybe that was a container ability. I don't know. All I know is Bernier City is screwed. Oh yeah, this part. A can shoots out and breaks the glass. I don't know if there's anything hidden behind these screens. It doesn't appear to be. Now we get a rather interesting area. Oh, and another hidden container. Oh, it's enough for now. Oh, so we are still on track to getting the container abilities, maybe. Interesting. Fairly certain that I did miss at least one or two. This area seems to be very icy for some reason. There we go. Really, I don't know what's up with the super jump. Maybe we did get it from the containers. If I remember correctly, that water is deadly, so... I guess it is, it's deadly cold. Yeah, now suddenly we're in a not icy cave. Probably more of that reality warping stuff that this base was working on. Documents down there. I think we have to walk up the edge of the ladder. Or no, we walk up it, climb it from the other side. Okay. Pretty sure that's dangerous. Oh, yes it is. Okay, let's jump up onto this. Okay. Okay, gotta be some way to get this big fan on. Or we could just climb up here. Oh, that's not good. Thank you.
My friend went there and never came back.
It's not actually possible to get up there, is it? Well, at least we know falling down there is instant death. Yeah, that's definitely not where we go either. Not sure if we're supposed to go up or down from... Oh. Well, I guess that answers the question. Okay, I think that's the way we go. Maybe? No, actually, it might be that way. All right. Doors are hard to see in this area. I remember in an earlier version, this is another area that was pretty painful to navigate due to how dark it was. And we got zombies here. Oh shoot, that locked us in. Okay, there wasn't actually anything over here. Oh my gosh, why did I think I came through the door? Okay then. Yep, even though a nuke tore through this place, these mutant zombies are still alive. Anyway, I think this here would be a good spot to end this episode, so yeah. Next time, through the remains of the destroyed city. See ya, everyone.